amplifiers produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc., Mobile Solutions, and CT Sounds. Come see what we're all about on Instagram. Be sure to follow and leave us a comment to say hi. You sick sons of bitches, you're back for more? I was telling all these horrible jokes to try to shut my YouTube channel down. I was trying to get fired. But instead, today, I'm gonna solder some copper lugs on all my power connections so I can hook up a circuit breaker under my hood and get this show on the road. I can't stop smiling like this. This 8-gauge power wire is going to be running all the way from my battery up to the Audison processor slash amplifier that's behind the dash. Amplifiers need these thicker runs of power and ground wire because they need to be able to suck the appropriate amount of amperage out of the battery and convert it into watts. The amount of power you have is going to determine how loud your system is. The more power you have, the louder your stereo gets. Anytime you want to run a power wire from your battery to an amplifier, you need to put a fuse directly off the battery. This fuse is going to protect the car from any shorts, because if your power wire shorts out and it's connected right to the battery, it's going to burn down, blow your damn car up, it's going to be a f***ing mess. There's going to be blood and guts all over the f***ing freeway. Your brain is going to be splattered out, not looking like much because it's small. Cop's going to step on it, think it was a Skittle. Didn't taste the rainbow, he stepped on it. All because you didn't put a fuse on your f***ing shit. You know who did taste the rainbow? Rafa's mom when I painted a rainbow on my pecker. There's also a fuse on the amp itself. This fuse kills power to the amp's internal power supply if there's an internal short of any kind. If an amp has a 40 amp fuse on it, we know it's not going to draw any more than 40 amps, because if it drawed 40 amps, the fuse would pop. I'm going to put a 60 amp circuit breaker under the hood right off my yellow top Optima battery. I opened my hood, it's so dirty, I don't even know what happened. I just got this truck 5 years ago. Time flies when you have PTSD from Rafa's mom falling on your head at the nightclub. That bitch f***ed me up. the hell happened in here? Rafa's mom threw a burrito on my fan propeller. Last time I had a temporary fuse holder under the hood. You want to see how to make a temporary fuse holder? Alright, here's how you make a free temporary fuse holder. You just take one of these, crimp it. Take another one of these bad boys, boom. Slap it in, crimp it. You take your fuse and you stick it right in the tab. You take a piece of tape. Don't try that cheap shit at home. I'm just trying to tell you I've done it before. I'm not trying to say it's good. And there you go, boys and girls. If you have to hook up power and you don't have a fuse holder, a temporary fuse holder is better than no fuse holder. But careful it doesn't wiggle out and touch metal and burn your car down. I'm gonna put this last lug on under the hood because I already ran my power wire. I'm not about to pull it back out just to solder it outside of the car. But it's a good idea to put all your ends on the wire before you put your wire in the car. I always learned that you run the power wire from the battery to the fuse holder and you don't loom that wire, but you loom the wire from the fuse holder back to the vehicle. So that's what I do. And that's what Ford did too. They have this wire coming from the terminal to their fuse block, not loomed. And then the rest of the wires coming out are loomed. I don't know why that's a rule, but I don't want to find out what happens if you loom it. It could blow up. All my lugs are soldered and pull tested. I put the end up Rafa's mom's butt, had her clinch down, and yanked the wire. They all survived. My vehicle's protected with this 60 amp circuit breaker right next to my yellow top Optima battery. This time I'm taking my time, make sure everything's perfect before I install my plate, because this time it's gonna work. Make sure you go over to our producer's Instagram pages, Soundman Enterprises Inc., Mobile Solutions, and CT Sounds. Follow us, leave a comment, and say hi. Thank you for watching, guys. Happy Monday. We'll see you here Tuesday at 8 a.m. for Amplified Season 7. We got daily episodes coming at you 5 days a week. Oh, no, we didn't.